thank you very much. Welcome to the 2017 Sydney Cup. Down under here in beautiful Sydney, Australia. 14th ranked Stanford getting set to tangle with the Rice Owls out of Conference USA. Alongside of Tom Ramsey, Roy Philpott, Sean Maloney, Quinn Kesnick will join us on the sideline momentarily. And the two head men leading the charge for both of these programs, David Shaw, another sensational 10-win campaign last year, Tom, and David Bailiff, who could be in search of some wins this year in 2017.
Yeah, David Bailiff coming off a 3-win season, not meeting his expectations by any means. They come off a year with a lot of injuries. And then on the flip side, David Shaw really has his program humming, going to 6 straight bowl games, and he's in search of another this year.
For Keller Chris, he's back as well after the Sun Bowl injury and the win against North Carolina. He tore his ACL, and amazingly enough, number 10 in white is back in action.
Absolutely remarkable recovery by Keller Chris, who got hurt in the Sun Bowl late in the first quarter on a run play. And he's been back. He missed some of spring ball, but he was ready for fall camp. And he did quite the work in the fall camp and has really emerged as a leader of this offense.
Making his first start in his first action for the Rice Owls after redshirting last year, Sam Glazeman. He admitted to us this week he's a bit nervous down under, but the coaches for the Owls very confident with his ability.
Well, redshirt freshman comes in, it's his first start, and I'd say he's playing against a very tenacious defense in Stanford. There's a lot of familiarity. These two teams teed it off last year. It was the last regular season game for Rice, and the backup, Jackson Tyner, got the first start of his career in that game, but Glazeman won it out in camp, and I'm sure Stanford's going to throw some different looks at him today.
Cardinal in all white, Rice with their navy blue, and Stanford, when the opening coin toss, will receive. Fox kicks it 5 yards deep. And the touchback. So our first look at Keller Chris. We mentioned the ACL injury. He is undefeated as a starting quarterback, Tom, 6-0 after taking over for Ryan Burns last year, and he could be a developing story in the Pac-12 this season.
Yeah, Keller Chris, when you go back and look at last year and what he's able to do, of course, he's a son of a coach. His father, Jeep, is the tight end coach with the Denver Broncos. His uncle, Paul, just happens to be the head coach at the University of Wisconsin. So he's been around the game for a long time, but Keller Chris has full control of this offense, and I expect him to run a lot of different packages today and get him in some really good throwing situations.
Multiple tight end formation as Irwin goes in motion. Cardinal 10-3 last year. 8 straight bowl games. The deep handoff to Bryce Love. A little stutter step. And Bryce Love off to the races on his first play from scrimmage. Finally ushered out of bounds just short of the 10-yard line by Justin Bickham. Nearly took it to the house.
Well, you talked a moment ago, Roy, about finding some substitutions for Solomon Thomas and Christian McCaffrey. I think Stanford just found the replacement right there. Bryce Love hitting the hole, and he's up the field, and he almost breaks it. Just a shoelace tackle there slowed him down, and, boy, you see his explosiveness right there.
Gain of 63 yards. Stanford in business on its first possession. Cardinal picks second, rugged Pac-12 North. Right behind Washington on first down. Chris have that one batted down. It'll be second down and 10.
That big number 99, Preston Gordon, getting his hand up that time, knocking the ball away as it came out of Chris' hands.
The junior out of McKinney, Texas. Conversations with both of these coaching staffs this week. They've treated it like a bowl game leading up to this afternoon's kickoff. It is just after noon here in Sydney for those wondering back home. 14 hours ahead of the East Coast. Second and 10 coming up for Chris and the Cardinal to the end zone. Back shoulder toss. And it is caught for the touchdown. The tight end Parkinson makes the grab. He's been spending time this offseason in the slot from 13 yards out, and just like that, Stanford on the board, Tom.
Colby Parkinson, all of 6'7", 230 pounds out of Oaks Christian in Los Angeles, and They just get the matchup they want. They're one-on-one with the corner who's about 5'10". And that's an easy throw for Keller Chris. Keep the ball up. Parkinson with a nice grab and control of the ball comes down with a touchdown.
75 yards in three plays and quite a statement for Stanford.
Yeah, they made it look easy.
Toner on for the extra point. This Aussie crowd. One of their favorite moments, of course. You love the rugby, you love the Australian rules football. Any kind of kicking is a good thing. And for Stanford, off and running here in 2017. Back in beautiful Australia, here in Sydney, look at the Manly Beach. Manly Beach, they call it. Beautiful town. Some 4 million Australian citizens live here in Sydney. Tom Ramsey, Roy Philpott, and a quick start for the Stanford Cardinal. The longest run of Bryce Love's career, 63-yarder, that set up the first scoring strike for Keller Crist. And Rice set to receive the football for the first time. About 55 degrees for kickoff. It is wintertime in Sydney. It's been a great week for all of us. Jack Baylor will kick things off for the Cardinal, dressed in all white. Some 30,000 fans expected for this game this afternoon. It is Sunday afternoon for those wondering. Here down under. From 3 yards deep. And sacked just past the 10-yard line. It'll be first and 10 for the Owls. Making his first start, Sam Blaisman. Quint Kestick has more on the redshirt freshman.
I was standing next to him during the national anthem and he exhaled deeply, trying to control his emotions. You see, his dream growing up was to be a Division I quarterback. He verbalized that to his brother when he was in middle school. 3 weeks ago, he was named starter. He called his mom, Mary Lou. Got so choked up, he cried on the phone. Today, the fulfillment of a dream. Seemed a little nervous and tense during warm-ups. Shocker. Let's see how he handles it.
Tears, tears of happiness.
And just 5 seconds remaining. And off of play action. Oh, the handoff. Sandwiched inside the one. Second down and long coming up. Eric Cotton made the stop. Samuel Stewart, the starting running back, 45 in blue for David Bailiff. Billy Lynch is high energy. We talked to him this week, and Coach Bailiff said that he's been a knucklehead down on the sidelines. He wants him up in the booth because he is not necessarily so high strung, but just has a lot going on and wants to get that right play call time. Second down and 19. And a short pickup. Make it third down again from inside the five. Harrison Phillips, the talented defensive tackle with a stop. Big number 66 in white. He's a talker as well, isn't he?
Well, he is. And he's one of the guys on that defensive front that really has to fill the void of Solomon Thomas. He actually helped Solomon Thomas a year ago because Harrison Phillips does such a great job holding the point from that nose tackle position. It allowed Thomas to free up and make a lot of tackles. Right now, he's the leader of the trenches.
Soup of the handoff. And nothing going for Rice on its first possession. What a start for Stanford. Two teams ended last season in the regular season. Phillips makes another hit.
Yeah, Phillips again right there. They can't get by the big nose tackle.
It's 41-17, Stanford holding serve at home in that win. Quinn, how about the perspective down there on the field for this punt for Rice?
This is about an 11-yard snap. Jack Fox has got to catch this one step and get it out. There's no space to operate. He's got to watch his feet, not stepping on the end line.
And Fox get it out cleanly as Tyler calls for the fair catch, muff the football. It'll be first and 10 for Stanford when we come back. Slow start for Rice. Weddington in the backfield for the first time. Chris, sensing the backfield pressure, throws it incomplete. To the pocket collapse that time. That'll bring up second down and 10. Chance coming in on the backside, Tom.
Yeah, Grayson Chance coming from the defensive end position. A lot of pressure that time on Keller Christ. And really forced him into a bad throw, almost an interception.
talented tight end Dalton Schultz. Set up shop on the right side of the Stanford offensive front. And here's Bryce Love. The jitterbug. A jump cut and shoved out of bounds near the 30. That'll be another chain mover for the Cardinal after a gain of 15 yards.
Well, here's what Stanford, that play really exemplifies what Stanford does well, Roy. They just get hat on hat. They block people right at the point of attack. They put Bryce Love in space so he can go one-on-one against the tackler, and he runs right by eBay.
Asked David Shaw this week, Bryce Love in three words: dynamic, explosive, physical. Surprising power. Empty backfield for the first time as Stanford will show its spread formation. Irwin has it. He needed 10. He'll pick up 13 as he pushes the pile forward. And the drive continues after Stanford started in plus territory with this possession.
Well, Keller Chris needed a completion there, Roy. He was 1 of 5 to start the game with a touchdown, but that throw to Irwin right there really allows them keep moving the chains, and that's what they want to do. They're really concerned about time of possession. They're concerned about their third down efficiency. David Shaw, the hallmark again of his offense, keep those chains moving.
Probably not entirely healthy for this season opener. A.T. Hall, the right tackle, out. Did not make the trip. J.J. Arcega-Whiteside also warmed up but not playing. Stripped up is Caden Smith, another one of those talented tight ends. Tom, that gives us a second, too, to think about how great the tight end position could be for Stanford this year. They've got some horses.
Well, they really do. Dalton Schultz, of course, a captain. He's a senior. And then we saw early on the touchdown by Colby Parkinson, who can obviously spread out wide as well. Caden Smith, who just made the catch. They really do have a lot of guys. And then when they go short yardage goal line, they bring in an offensive guard, Roy. Nick Wilson comes in, and he becomes the motion guy and the lead blocker.
High formation as Cameron Scarlett checks in for the first time. Stanford shows power. And Scarlett punched forward. Needed 2, gained 3. And the 7th play of the drive will extend it at least 4 more downs.
Well, in Stanford, of course, being a Power 5 school, playing a Conference USA team out of the Group of 5 in Rice here, they can lean on people. They have the bulk. They have the muscle. Stanford can start wearing you out. And that, again, is what Mike Blumgren, the offensive coordinator, said to us. He's going to keep pounding the ball. They're going to keep running it. And then, of course, you can play action out of that.
Schultz marks the fullback. Scarlett, the handoff, pushes forward. That's a touchdown. The Cardinal on the board once again, showing power and coming through for 22 and wide. It's 13-0.
Well, just mano a mano. When Stanford gets in that short yardage goal line, they get low. They push people off the line of scrimmage. And Cameron Scarlett powers over for the score. But right there, it's just domination at the line of scrimmage.
Toner back on the field for another extra point attempt. Sophomore from Honolulu, Hawaii. And right between the pipes. Well, a picture-perfect start for the Stanford Cardinal. A picture-perfect afternoon here in the Sydney Harbor. Well, it was a 15-hour flight from LAX to make it down here to Sydney, Australia, in beautiful New South Wales. And the Rice players trying to stay loose during that flight. You got to stretch just to make sure you're going to be okay after getting off that airplane, Tom. That's a long flight.
I stretch while I sleep.
It's another way to do it. A slow start for the Owls. They'll have it first and 10 from the 25. So we check in once again with our good friend Quint Kesnick.
Yeah, and I'm joined by Sean Maloney, who's on our team today. Thankfully, the big man, 10 years as a professional rugby player. He's a current commentator. We're close and up front and personal right now with these Stanford athletes. What are your impressions?
These blokes are enormous, but the similarities are very, very close to rugby union in that we've got these different body shapes, some a little shorter, a little squatter, some real big ranger units as well. And that's what we're used to seeing played here at Allianz Stadium. Rugby union, a little bit of rugby league as well. It is so good having everyone in town. This week has been enormous.
As you watch this first quarter, what position do you think you would have played? What are you, good 6'5"? You could be as big as one of these tackles.
I'll take TE, and I'd hate to try and catch a guy like Love. He is lightning.
So you'd be a tight end?
I would,
because you can handle.
I can handle all day long.
What stands out about the flow of the game so far in terms of the pace? And if I'm an Australian fan, do I really understand what I'm seeing?
You do. We are a really, really switched on sporting unit down here. And when it comes down to Super Bowl, it is massive. All across Sydney, pubs and clubs full to the brim, cheering whoever. They don't even have to have a side. They'll cheer and cheer and cheer all day long. And they'll do that here today as well.
A pub on every corner. A bookmaker on every corner.
It can be a dicey recipe, let me tell you. A real dicey recipe.
Where's the smart money today?
I was just going off the feedback you guys are giving this week, and I was with the guys that are behind us. They look pretty sharp early on.
Well, thank you, Sean. He'll be joining us periodically throughout this broadcast, Roy.
We appreciate that, Quint. Somewhere, Britt Musburger with a nod to our broadcast today. Third down and 7 coming up for Rice after the shovel pass to Jordan Myers.
Well, now I know at least Sean's a Patriots fan, right? He's dialed in on the Super Bowl.
Yes, he is.
It's a tough third down for Rice here.
And the Owls need to sustain something here after this slow start. And the pass looped towards midfield. It is out of bounds, incomplete. Aaron Cephas, the intended receiver, and Elijah Holder now healthy in coverage on the first passing attempt on this sunsplash afternoon by the Owls.
Rice is just not crisp on offense, Roy. I told you the other day when I watched them practice and then we went out a second time that they weren't perfect. And you have to be perfect on offense. Of course, with a new quarterback, that's part of the struggles. You have to get the timing with the receivers right there trying to get the ball to Aaron Cephas down the sideline. The ball actually drifted him out of bounds.
Wind will be a factor today, blowing from left to right as Fox will turn that punt over beautifully. Tyler retreats inside of his 20. And with real estate, a little shake and bake ushered out short of the 35-yard line. A punt of 54, first and 10 for Stanford coming up. Back here in beautiful Sydney, Australia, first down carry for Bryce Love. A short pickup, it'll be second down. Allianz Stadium, the home this year's Sydney Cup, also the home of the Sydney Roosters. The Rugby League here down under. Tom Ramsey, Roy Philpott, Sean Maloney, Quint Kesnick down on the sidelines. A beautiful day for American football. A great start for 14th ranked Stanford as Christ. It's the shotgun snap. Rise some time. There's his tight end, Dalton Schultz. Third different tight end to catch a pass, including touchdown reception by Colby Parkinson. That's a 17-yard pickup.
Nice play, nice patience that time by Keller Chris, really standing in the pocket and finding his veteran receiver. Dalton Schultz, one of the captains, just continues to work open there. And nice representation of American footy.
American footy, that's it.
Yeah.
Good day. Play action looking for Schultz. We'll dump it off to Scooter Harrington. Another positive pickup. Kama makes the stop. Now the keys for David Shaw, it all comes down to efficiency.
There's no foul for an ineligible receiver downfield. The pass was caught behind the line of scrimmage. Second down.
Well, second down and short. First down efficiency, third down efficiency, turnovers and plus the red zone.
It's keeping it simple, right? You have to get good gains on first down. In order to manage the clock and keep the clock in your favor, you always got to be good on third down. Turnovers is the easiest one yet, but when you get down to the red zone, you have to convert, and you don't want field goals, you want touchdowns.
Out of the power eye once again, Bryce Love. A spin move and another first down.
We're done, men, we're done.
as the drive continues for Stanford. Well, Rice this year led by a new defensive play caller in Brian Stewart, formerly of the Dallas Cowboys. Spent the last couple of seasons as the defensive backs coach at Nebraska. And we talked to him, we asked about taking over down in Houston with his Owls program, and he said he liked what he saw on film to transition from the 4-2-5 to the 3-4 scheme. And so far this defense not paying dividends the way that he envisioned.
No, and they have to be able to get off the field at some point, make a stop.
The swing pass, there's Weddington, second touch, a nice move inside the 10. And hit forward by Hanusa. Roe Wilkins will still be second and short.
Well, Weddington's an interesting guy. They didn't quite know where they wanted to fit him, whether at running back or slot or wide out. I think he's finding a home kind of as that slot guy. Really the same pass he got earlier in this quarter.
And if you're a fan of Stanford, old number 5 looks pretty good.
pretty dynamic.
This offense already 3 plays going 10 yards or longer thus far. On this possession alone, and there's Bryce Love. His first touchdown, replacing Christian McCaffrey. And thank you very much, the Cardinals score once again.
Well, Bryce Love again just taking a slight handoff by Keller Chris, the quarterback, and they really got exactly what they wanted. They pulled the guard around and they get a nice hat on hat again. And Bryce Love is so quick to the end zone right there. No one can touch him.
Just over 4 minutes, a 7-play scoring drive for Stanford, their third of this first quarter. And a 21-0 lead for the Cardinal out of the Pac-12. How about these numbers already over the century mark? Ellery goes back deep for Rice. Backup running back David Shaw, he was so confident, we mentioned that you couldn't have dialed it up much better than this, the weather or Stanford's start. It's Bailey. Knocked that one out of bounds. So decent field position for the first time for the Owls. On first down, out of the shotgun, Blaisman with time and an open receiver and a pitch and a catch and a first down now in plus territory. A nice looking throw and a gain of 18 yards.
And throwing the ball on first down always changes things up, going to the veteran tight end, Robbie Wells, and they're in a hurry up now.
Handoff goes to Stewart, now healthy, leading rusher for Rice last season as he ducks out of bounds inside the 45.
It's not always first game jitters too. I think a lot of programs across the country and internationally as well, you don't know what your tempo is. You don't know what full speed is in game time, right? You got to get the game speed, and it's hard to get the game speed, especially in the first game of the season for anybody.
Billy Lynch told us our identity is going to be running the football. Got to be able to run it. It's cliche. So far that has not happened for Rice. Walter in motion. And the near side handoff is Stewart. Move the sticks. Sam Stewart, 5'9", redshirt junior from Cypress, Texas. A gain of 8, a nice looking play for the Owls.
Well, and Stewart had some success back in late November of last year against the Stanford Cardinal defense. He had 13 rushes for 77 yards. And right there, he was able to reach the corner and then turn it up and make a nice gain. So they got 2 first downs. That's a positive sign for Rice. Now they need to make sure they do something in this venture into the red zone territory.
Wells in motion this time. We are seeing a faster tempo than we expected from Rice. Blaisman will show the option as Stewart hauled out inside the 35, a short pickup. We should mention as well our thoughts and prayers with everybody back in the Houston area and the Gulf Coast of Texas. This tropical depression, tropical storm, Harvey barreling down on the Gulf Coast. And for these Rice players and coaches, that has been, well, not necessarily a distraction, but they have been focused on a lot of their family members back home this week.
Yeah,
and everything that's happened there.
Yep.
Usually a gain of one, second down and nine. Power set with Walter in motion this time. Stewart dives across the 30.
Nice play that time by Peter Kalambayi, the outside linebacker. Again, in their previous game back in November, they had success with that short option into the sideline. And a year ago, the plays were made by Solomon Thomas, the great defensive end who went third round, or actually third pick of the NFL draft to the 49ers. But I was talking to Lance Anderson, the defensive coordinator, before the game. I said, hey, didn't Thomas make the whole play last year? He said, yeah, he made him pitch and he made the tackle.
And that's what happens when you're the number three overall pick. Wells couldn't corral it. 5 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Rice, critical play coming up in decision time now for the Owls. On fourth down.
Yeah, I think they stay on the field, go for it here. David Bailiff told us yesterday, he said he's not really wanting to kick field goals. They got to come away with 6 points on their ventures into the red zone. The ball just got to Wells a little quick right there. I think again what they do is move the pocket a little bit, give Glazeman a little bit of room and run pass option.
Empty backfield, low snap sent to Glazeman, tries to buy some time, a flag on the field. Well short of the first down, lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage. Alfieri, Kalambayi combined to make the stop.
Holding offense number 76, that penalty is declined. The ball will go over to Stanford on downs. First down Stanford, that's the end of the first quarter.
Now here at the Sydney Cup, a fast start for the nation's number 14 team. Early touchdown strike from Keller Chris and the Cardinal, a 3-touchdown lead. Stanford out in front of Bryce. Coming to you live from Sydney, Australia, home of Adrenaline Sport. Learn more about this beautiful city, plan your trip at sydney.com today. The Cardinal in business once again, already spotted his 21-point advantage. First down carry goes for 10 as Scarlett continues his good work this afternoon.
Well, Stanford doing good work in the first quarter, Roy. 186 total yards. Rice had 42. Plus 10, they're knocking on the 200-yard mark and just entered the second quarter. Pretty dominant at the line of scrimmage. Stanford's been really pushing the line of scrimmage, those big linemen really leaning on the defensive line of Rice.
Rest out of the shotgun with time, nearly picked off. It's Emmanuel Ellerby, the first time we've called his name today, the Conference USA Defensive Player of the Year. He's just named this preseason. Probably should have had that one.
Yeah, we haven't called his name, and I expect we will. He had 7 games a year ago with double-digit tackles. He had 118 total tackles on the year. And when you think about how many tackles per game, you know, 10.7 per game, it was sixth in FBS. Quite a feat.
So as a civil engineering major, wants to design stadiums when he's done playing football. As Love punches through once again, a nice stutter step. Inside plus territory, hit forward inside the 30 by Justin Bickham. And what a start for Bryce Love, replacing Christian McCaffrey, a gain of 31.
And what they're able to do, Bryce Love is able to get to the second level immediately. Watch, hat on hat again, they come down, they down block, all of a sudden Bryce Love, next level, and he's making moves, not on linebackers, he's putting moves on DB. So they get the linebacker blocked, and they have receivers downfield. V.J. Banks, 19, missed him, and then Justin Bickham came over and finally got him down.
And what they're calling the year of the quarterback, Bryce Love may have something to say about that. Here's Scarlett, all kinds of real estate, makes a nice move towards the end zone, and another Stanford touchdown. His second of this first half, this time from 29 yards out.
again, great execution at the point of attack for Stanford, following the big left tackle, David Bright, and behind the guard, Nate Herbig, also known as Big Island amongst his teammates, hailing from Hawaii, but boy, Scarlett made it look easy.
I'm glad you finally mentioned the offensive line. We haven't given the Big Uglies the kind of love they deserve down under. They've had a great week of practice, according to David Shaw and also Mike Bloomgren, offensive play caller for the Cardinal. Could be the top offensive line of the Pac-12 by the time it's all said and done. 28-0 Stanford here in Sydney. A quick start for the Pac-12. Fort Denison, the Sydney Harbor. There's the bridge in the background. More on that later. The Opera House. There's so many great attractions down under. Tom Ramsey, Roy Philpott, 28-0. An impressive start for the nation's 14th-ranked team. Quinn Kesnick and also Sean Maloney joining us on the field later here in the second quarter. Sam Blaisman, the redshirt freshman, under center this time. And the end around, net positive yards into plus territory, a gain of four. It's Casey Tuhill will bring down Cameron Montgomery.
First time we're seeing Cameron Montgomery, the true freshman out of Stafford, Texas. Just so happens he's a 10 300 meter guy. So why not give him a chance at the jet sweep, see if he can get some yards. I like the last two possessions for Rice. When they went up tempo, they've been able to manage some yards. They just haven't been able to close out a drive yet.
For the Rice defense, held for the first time. Another shovel pass, third one of his first half. And no gain on the play. It's Colin Bailly. Going to bring that one down quickly.
A lot of misdirection in this offense. Billy Lynch, the offensive coordinator. I think sometimes, Roy, misdirection slows you down. I think sometimes you got to go vertical. You got to take your shots. But the key is establishing a run game. You have to get the run game, and that is in their DNA. They do want to establish the run game.
Billy Lynch, offensive play caller, taking over. He's been with this program now for more than seven seasons. On third down, a floater for Walter, in and out of the pass. Austin Walter, converted running back. His twin brother now plays running back in his old position. Alexander and Holder in coverage.
Yeah, Terrence Alexander making a nice play that time of the ball. Got his head around. Ball kind of hung up just a little bit. It's a tough throw down the sideline. It's not going to be a high percentage pass by any means.
Rice 0 for 5 on third down, and how about some credit for the Stanford defense replacing Solomon Thomas? It's not been an issue thus far. Fox are very busy. A couple of quarters here in Sydney. Bounces that one into the end zone. Stanford football when we return.
Going back to David Shaw, I think he's very calculating in his play calling, but it comes from preparation and really good preparation.
Fake to Scarlett, the wheel route to the other side, and 22 finally corrals it. There he goes, brought down almost inside the 15, and that'll be first and goal for Stanford. That's a gain of 55 yards, and Scarlett did a great job just to finally bring that pigskin in.
Remarkable that he stayed with the ball and didn't drop it. He tried to drop it. You only get credit for one catch there, even though you catch it three times. But again, David Shaw, knowing when he's man on man on the backside, and the linebacker wasn't even with Scarlett that time, but running the wheel route, which is a staple part of this offense.
High formation, Parkinson down, the intended receiver again, some contact. No flag, he already has one touchdown reception today. It's 84 and White.
Nice play by V.J. Banks. The corner just stripping the arm away from Colby Parkinson, and Parkinson was looking for a flag by the ref, but I thought it was a good play again by Banks.
So Parkinson retreats to the sideline. And Ryan Burns now, your new Stanford quarterback. you wondered who we would see first between Burns and Costello. Turns out to be the former Stanford signal caller. Calls his own number, brought down just short of the goal line. JT Ebe with the hit to prevent the touchdown.
The field is if the quarterback is short of the goal line, third down.
Well, and that play for Ryan Burns right there, Roy, is really representative of where he came from in high school at Stonebridge High out of Leesburg, Virginia. He ran that particular play quite a bit, and he was really kind of the non-throwing quarterback that came into the as a Stanford Cardinal quarterback.
Christ back in. And they'll bring in the extra beef with Nick Wilson, who goes in motion. Scarlett, an easy score, his third of the first half. We've talked a lot about Bryce Love. How about Cameron Scarlett? The great job that he has done. A couple of rushing touchdowns and the 55-yard reception moments ago.
Well, they just get big play after big play, and then they're able to punch it in. And I think, again, going back to that red zone efficiency. But you mentioned Nick Wilson coming into the game, Roy, and from that left end, that wing position, he just collapses the entire defensive line of Rice, and it's an easy touchdown for Cameron Scarlett.
51 rushing yards, 56 receiving yards, and three touchdowns for Scarlett. Oh, Chris, thank you very much. And I think we did count 17 players in the line of scrimmage at one point for Stanford, including 14 tight ends. That's how they do it out there on the left coast. Great start for the Cardinal. Blazeman incomplete. Tight coverage against Lance Wright, who's now healthy, recovering from a torn ACL. Murphy in coverage. Well, there's been a lot of talking after Alabama's loss to Clemson in the national championship game. Crimson Tide opened the year, obviously, number one. And Nick Saban's won four national titles in Tuscaloosa, so you can understand why, plus Jalen Hurts. A lot of times that number one team finding success in that opening weekend. But for Florida State and DeAndre Francois, Derwin James is back. There's a lot of storylines in Atlanta for that one. Stewart hit hard and brought down 7 yards behind the line by Jordan Fox. Fox, a sophomore from Plainfield, New Jersey, a big hit for the linebacker. Give it to me right now. Bama or Florida State? Who are you going with next week?
I'm going to go Florida State. I think Jimbo Fisher, DeAndre Francois, I had him in the bowl game, the Orange Bowl. I'm always so impressed with Jimbo Fisher's game planning. I just think their attention to detail is remarkable. And Clemson broke the magic of Bama.
Experts thinking along those lines. Glazeman will float that one out of bounds under duress.
There's no foul for intentional grounding. The quarterback was out of the pocket when he threw the ball.
Colin Bailly applying the pressure. Rice now 0 for 6 on third down. My question for you is Florida State's offensive line, a weakness last year. Have they beefed it up enough up front to handle Alabama? Then again, Bama lost a lot of its defensive standouts.
They did, and I think, you know, what Dabo Swinney and Clemson what they were able to do in the championship game, Roy, was really special. Now, Deshaun Watson, you and I can't agree on something. He was a really special player.
Stanford.
Fox. We'll send it to Tyler Deep. And after a nifty move, a couple of penalty flags on the field upon a 58 with an 8-yard return.
10 years as a pro rugby player, you're played in the second row.
That's right, second row.
Was the ball in your hands and in your control?
Often, so second row, you're the man jumping. You're going to the top
you're
of the line.
Jumper?
Out. Well, it'd take a forklift on occasion to get me up, but yes.
It would take a forklift right now, I'll tell you that much. So you were a jumper. Who's the lifter?
The forklift, generally. Yeah, we need some heavy machinery. No, the prop. A prop lifts the second rower. So as I was saying earlier, Quinn, a number of these guys are making terrific props, and a couple of guys, great locks as well.
I would make neither a prop or a lock. I'd be more of a drop.
Yeah, that could work for you. I can see that working out for you.
And kicking. kicking this ball. What's that like? What's it entail?
Generally, you're only going to hit that around 50 metres. That's hard. So that's hard to send
that's
long
far.
Distances.
That's good. That's
great
good,
for handling, though. Great for handling. Even you can hang on to this one, no problems.
Can you give me a pass?
Of course, I'll give you a pass.
After this play,
it's going to be tricky with a one hand. I'm going to see how you go catching.
I'm going to put my mic down. You put your mic down.
Okay. Are you ready for this?
I'm ready.
Okay.
There it is. Nice job, Q.
There you go. Don't go passing. Don't go passing. Your catching's great. Don't go passing.
I'd rather throw it overhand.
Guys, thank you very much. The Stanford drive continues. That was a 27-yard pitch and catch to another tight end, Dalton Schultz. And Chris has been silky smooth to start this season at the quarterback position. Yeah, you got Australian rules football down here. You got rugby. There's subtle differences, really major differences, as Cameron Scarlett checks back into the backfield. Keller Chris with a straight face tried to tell us he didn't know who the second game was against. We had to call him out on that one, Keller. Come on. Make him in coverage. Pass incomplete. 9 seconds remaining.
Chris that time trying to get the ball to Donald Stewart, but players always look ahead. We're like, hey, we'll help you out. Here's your schedule. And they have SC on September 9th. They have UCLA September 23rd, and they play at San Diego State in between. So they're going to play all of Southern California in about 3 weeks.
Lump flanks out the top of the screen. Schultz, a hard collision. The ball came out. Pass is incomplete. With a few mistakes he's made, Bertrand in coverage, laying the wood that time.
And I think the Stanford offense, just going back to Quint's original question, was that their offense is so vast, it really, they'll dictate to the defense. And see Keller Chris trying to thread the ball down the middle of the field. That's a nice low angle shot, trying to get the ball to Dalton Schultz. Nice play by the defense that time.
Here's Chet Toner. David Shaw telling us this week that fairly comfortable back to 45 yards. This one from 40 yards out. On the way, and he'll sneak that one just inside the left upright. 38-0 our score. We send it back to Chris Cotter. Chris, hey, back here in Sydney, Australia. Great look at the Sydney Harbor. Sydney Harbor Bridge, the Opera House. What a day it has been for the Stanford Cardinal. 38-0 lead against Rice as we take a look at our first half stats. And boy, Rice held to under 100 yards of total offense. Cardinal defense has been the story, not to mention Bryce Love and Cameron Scarlett.
Yeah, I think total yards alone, Roy, 404 total yards for Stanford in the first half. 71, you mentioned. And then 0-for-6 on third down. Rice just not able to convert today.
And the short kick, fielded inside the 10, brought back short of the 25-yard line. Oh, great to have you with us. Tom Ramsey, Roy Philpott, Quinn Kesnick, and also Sean Maloney down under here in Sydney, New South Wales, Australia. Tell you what, a picture-perfect day in terms of the weather, picture-perfect start for Stanford thus far.
Well, Stanford's doing it all right. They're doing it well. Rice has just had a tough time getting untracked, I think. And you come such a distance to play a game, and you want to be better on offense, definitely. Stanford has checked all the boxes so far. They're doing great on first down, good on third down, good in the red zone, and they haven't turned the ball over. So they're checking all of David Shaw's boxes thus far, and they have the lead to really back it up.
Rocky start for the redshirt freshman, Sam Glazeman. Confusion, was trying to attempt the shovel pass, and fortunate to make something out of nothing, brought down by Okereke. Quint, what else did you hear from Coach Bailiff?
Yeah, he was pretty positive, searching for rhythm on offense, and you guys spoke about it earlier, whether it's a huddle or an up-tempo. They've got to stop the self-inflicted wounds, whether it's false starts, delay of games, or drops. He was pretty encouraged with the play of his young quarterback, Sam Glazeman. And then defensively, got to win a one-on-one. So we haven't won a single one-on-one all day.
Walter in motion on second down and short after the scramble, and on the jet sweep, there goes Walter. Shoestring tackle crossing the 40 by Brandon Simmons for a gain of 17.
Well, and Stanford is just sound, right? They're sound on defense, they're sound on offense, and I think that's part of the frustration that Rice feels as well. Right there, Austin Walker comes with a jet sweep and tucks it up inside, gets a nice game. I just haven't seen Rice explode off the line of scrimmage. You know, that time there, Walter puts his foot in the ground, he gets north and south. I think that's what I want to see more out of this Rice offense in the second half. Glazeman, he was fair. He was 5 of 10 in the first half.
Longest run of the day for the Owls. They'll lose yardage on first down. Stewart ushered out for a loss of three. Justin Reed from his safety spot came up to make the stop.
And Roy, when Rice had some success in the first half, they went a little more up-tempo. And we do a lot of games back in the U.S. when teams thrive on the up-tempo, and it really puts the defense back on their heels. I think Rice, the one aspect they're missing, or at least today, when they've had success, it's been when they've gone up-tempo.
Empty backfield as Stewart motions out of your picture. A dangerous toss. Hits a turf. It'll be third down.
Well, when you go 4x1, they had four wides to the far side of the field. It attracts a lot of attention. You know, when you were swimming in the Sydney Harbor, yeah, and all those sharks, and the guy was chumming next to you, it was kind of like, Roy, probably don't want to go swimming here.
You know, I thought I was going to go swimming at one point, making the climb up the Sydney Harbor Bridge. More on that later. Some 438 feet in the air. A tourist spot down under. Rice 0 for 6 on third down in this one. Glazeman with a pocket collapsing escapes, but not for very much. Justin Reed, so an active start to his second half, along with Sean Barton combined to make the stop. No gain, and the punt team back on the field.
Well, Justin Reed, he get in nickel, he comes down and he becomes almost like a linebacker, and you see his ferocity right there going after Glazeman. Just a great play that time by number 8.
Jay Tyler back deep to receive this Fox punt once again for Rice. As the score indicates here to begin our second half, it has been all Stanford in Sydney. Fair catch of the 22, a punt of 39. Back with more after this. Tom Ramsey, Roy Philpott, Clint Kestick down on the sidelines along with Sean Maloney. Chris delivers a strike across the middle and tripped up close to the 50-yard line by Bickham. It's Trent Irwin. His first catch of the afternoon, a gain of 30 yards.
Yeah, Trent Irwin just running the crossing route. Puts a nice little move on his man, a little underneath coverage. And the Rice defense just haven't had the answers today. I mean, right there, Keller Chris with a lot of time to throw and then great protection. And he's able to find his man running scot-free and first down at the 50.
Eighth play of 20 yards or longer so far for Stanford. Chris, pocket collapses, fires it downfield. Stewart's got it at the 10. Now position that football perfectly. Thomas in coverage, the free safety. Gain of 40 yards on the play, and just outside the 10, it's a first down for Stanford.
And that's great body position by Donald Stewart to go up, high point the ball, put his hip on the man behind him, and really protect the throw. Comes down with a great catch.
Met his parents this week on one of the Sydney Harbor cruises we went on, and they were very excited about what number 8 is going to bring to the Stanford offense. Love back in there, a stutter step inside the 5. It'll be second down.
Well, part of their ground game is run between the tackles. Bryce Love lowering that shoulder. Bryce Love, pretty spectacular first half. Prior to that carry, 11 carries, 176 yards and a touchdown.
And David Shaw said something interesting, again asking about Love and his potential. He said, you know, he's not only our best running back at this point, also could be our best receiver. About what Christian McCaffrey brought to the table. A similar skill set, but lofty shoes to try to fill. And the jump ball completed to Parkinson. And our friends in LA are watching over at SC, and Parkinson, when he gets there inside the red zone, Second touchdown grab of the afternoon. He is a dangerous weapon, as is that cannon.
Yeah. Yeah, Colby Parkinson, all 6'7" of him, again, using his body and just really kind of, you know, puts his hip on the defender, and it's going up for a rebound. And he got up and high-pointed it. Another touchdown for him, two for the young freshman.
Almost 80 yards in just five plays. And the Cardinal leaning back quite nicely here in Sydney. Leading by 45 down under. 45-0 deficit. It has been all Stanford, as the nation's number 14th ranked program has lived up to the hype thus far. New quarterback is Jackson Tyner, redshirt sophomore. Started his first game of his career last year against his Stanford bunch. We'll see if this is a change of pace for the Rice offense. Deep handoff to Stewart up to the 30 for a gain of five. Robinson with the hit along with Mustafa Branch.
Yeah, Tyner didn't have great numbers in his start against Stanford last year. He was 10 of 37 for 68 yards. His other four games he played in, he was 22 of 30, 73% clip in the four other games. Kind of interesting, but Stanford had the answer.
Blaisman appeared to be shaken up a little bit on that last series. The rest at times today, Burns off the back foot, make that Tyner off the back foot. Up to the 45 and shoved out by Murphy. That's a gain of 15.
Blaisman on the sideline. His final line today, 5 of 13, 48 yards. 0 for 2, 0 for 3 in the second half. It was 5 of 10 at halftime.
Rice now recording its fifth first down. A lot of credit there to the Stanford defense, minus Solomon Thomas. Play action for Tyner. Drive continues now in plus territory. Tuhill will usher him out of bounds. Gain of 12.
Nice decision that time by Tyner. Really nothing downfield to look at, and he just tucked it under his arm and took off for the sticks, and it was a nice job there.
So you already gave me Florida State over Alabama. You have any other surprises this year, perhaps?
Oh, I have many. I have many. How deep would you like me to go in my little bag here? Well,
with 6 minutes left in the third, as deep as you would like.
Okay.
First down, confusion on the handoff, and picked up by Tuhill. The first turnover of the afternoon for Rice.
The ruling on the field is the ball was fumbled and recovered by Stanford for a first down.
Casey Tuhill, good young athlete out of Cathedral Catholic in San Diego, comes off the edge. And really just is aware that the ball's on the ground. And he picks it up, scoops it. Tyner, the quarterback, there to bring him down. Otherwise, he's got a free sail to the end zone.
Well, my surprise is this year, and we'll stick in the Pac-12 for a moment, the Stanford team in the North Division, Washington State. Luke Falk is back. Mike Leach is getting a little ornery up there in Pullman. He's ready. And I think he feels like his team this year is going to have an opportunity to really sneak up and do some damage.
So you're saying who in the Pac-12 North comes out?
I'm going to go with this team in a surprise. Now, okay. Stanford was dominated last year by the Cougars and the Huskies. So they got to fix that as Weddington, a one-handed catch inside the 20, spinning to make the grab and a pickup of 34.
Great play by Weddington and a nice throw by Ryan Burns that time. And I'm going to give you my Pac-12 North pick in a moment here, Roy, after we watch the replay, because Weddington does reach behind, pulls it in left-handed. What a play. Well, we know he can be an inside and outside threat. That's proven. I think the winner of the Pac-12 North, the winner of the Apple Cup.
It could be.
Washington State and Washington, they really manhandled Stanford last year and really gave them a great deal of business they couldn't handle. But I think the winner, and I think Mike Leach with Luke Falk, is loaded.
And Burns, the keeper. So the North Division of the Pac-12, you think, goes to the winner of the Apple Cup. You give me Florida State over Bama week one. Two surprises in. What's number three?
In the Pac-12, or are we going elsewhere?
Let's expand it.
I like, in the SEC, and you didn't like this one when I mentioned it. I like Kirby Smart and Georgia, and specifically Jacob Eason at quarterback for Georgia. I had them open the season last year against Mitch Trubisky and UNC down at the old Dome in Georgia, and I really was impressed with Jacob Eason. I think he's going to be a superstar.
Second down, Burns back to the air, touchdown. Another tight end, Caden Smith with the honors this time, 82 in white. Sophomore out of Flower Mound, Texas. And the Cardinal pouring it on here in Sydney.
Well, and here's what I know. If you're Clancy Pendergrass, the defensive coordinator at USC, you're thinking, okay, Stanford goes to the red zone, and they like their tight ends down there. That's who they've been going to. It's the third touchdown catch of a tight end today. Colby Parkinson with the two others. Caden Smith with his first of the season. Nice throw by Ryan Burns.
Toner back on for an extra point. Any jersey beginning with the number eight. Look out this year for the Cardinal. We check in once again with Quint and Sean, guys.
Trying to avoid the cannon we are here in the end zone. Australian rules football. This is Gary Rohan of the Sydney Swans. We've got Sean Maloney in the smoke.
In the smoke, the rice cannon just gone off.
He's
again.
He's a rugby guy.
It gets me every time.
Gary came out to practice, Stanford practice the other day, and we were punting the ball around, and I was blown away by your accuracy. Can you kick the ball to Sean and give the American fans an idea of why we are seeing so many Aussie kickers in the NFL and college football?
Nailed it. I won't try. Actually, I'll just toss it back to you guys.
Okay.
There you go.
That's a nice underhand toss there,
go.
Sean.
We're on a platter.
I love the bounce.
On a platter.
Now, as you back up.
Don't make me run.
The accuracy remains on target.
I'll move for you guys. And there it is.
Look at that, right in stride.
And what about the catch? Hey, Quinn, what about the catch?
So when I was watching the juniors, the 12-year-olds, just the punting, the accuracy, the repetition.
And the handball, too.
And the consistency.
Oh, we're going again.
How do you do it, Gary?
I just hold the punt. The laces go towards wherever you want to target. Make sure you drop it as low as you can towards your foot so it doesn't make any angle, so it makes it easier to kick, and make sure the ball spins backwards so your teammates is easier to catch.
Why don't you kick a spiral?
It's more accurate to kick the drop punt, where every now and then you'll hit the spiral to make it go a bit further, but it's more the drop punt you hit your teammate and make it easier for them to catch.
Take another one. And these athletes can kick right-footed, they can kick left-footed, and they also can make the ball move depending on your drop, correct? How do you do that?
Yeah, that's right. So we have a snap or a check side, or either way, which way you want to snap the ball to go, a snap to go that way, or check side to go the other way. And
nice hands, Quinn. We'll make an AFL player of you yet.
Last one, show us a little movement on a ball here, or a simulated
snap. Do me to a snap.
Snap.
So a snap, he's just got to bend it around.
There it goes. No catching.
Look at that
one.
Like a golf, that's my hook.
Yeah, pretty much.
Gary, thank you. Congratulations on the big win last night.
They're on the way to the big time.
Your kicking is different in rugby.
My kicking is like your passing.
Very good, Sean. Very good.
Gentlemen, thank you very much. Well done.
Number 21 for Stanford. His helmet came off. He has to leave the game for one play.
As we were talking there, Malik Antoine almost had a pick six. It was delivered right into his mitts. Couldn't quite corral it. Rice now facing a third down. You know, you've seen the rugby style kick a lot instituted into the sport of football. I mean, yep. American football, that is, college and the pros. They'll try to angle those punts towards the goal line, and you can get a backspin on it, or the low line drives. Walter across the middle, and a nice move into plus territory for Rice for a rare occasion today. That's a gain of 15, and a hit by Alexander. But I think we're going to see more of that because it creates confusion at times simply with the bounce of the ball defensively.
Yeah, having the ball kick back or rotate back, it's big. If you're punting it, right there, first down for Jackson Tyner to Walter, as you mentioned. That's a simple throw and catch. Walter just sitting down in a zone window, and that's as simple a first down as they had all day.
Hard hit on the backup quarterback Tyner as he spins for a gain of four. That was Jordan Fox.
Yeah, and I think the Stanford defense has put on a good show today. I think this right here, you're in two down territory to get, well, you're actually in four down territory to get the first down. My apology there, but I think if you're Rice, your goal here is to finish the drive, get points, and you don't want to settle for a field goal here.
Al's just 3-9 last season. David Bailiff, this is his 11th year with the Owls, as Tyner scampers out of bounds. He's won the title in Conference USA a couple of times, most recently in 2013, so he understands what it takes. But the natives get restless making this kind of trip and struggling at this level, not to mention 3-9 last year.
Well, and I'm sure they wanted more of a showing in this particular game against an opponent that they didn't face all too long ago. It was really their last game of 2016. They played at Stanford, and granted, it was in a rainstorm primarily in the second half, but you know, I thought Tyner, having started the game last year, he might have had a little more ability to win the job. That ball just sails out of bounds.
He was trying to hit Asupa, who slipped and fell as he made his cut on his route. Dylan Jackson applying the pressure. Rice a bit unlucky there, now facing a fourth down.
Yeah, and football is a great game with the attention to detail, right? You got to put in the work in the offseason. You got to come into fall camp prepared for a long grind. And, you know, both teams, talking to the coaching staffs, really felt as though they had productive and positive training camps, and one is showing today and the other one has yet to show it, although they're playing against a superior team.
Owls need seven. Tyner with time lofts it towards the end zone and overshoots his intended receiver, Aaron Cephas. Perez nearly got to him before the ball was released. New quarterback for the Cardinal, KJ Costello. David Shaw told us this week he perhaps has the highest ceiling when comparing him to Burns. And a quick pitch and catch there.
I'd say KJ Costello had a pretty productive high school career coming out of Southern California down at Cota de Casa, Santa Margarita Catholic. He went for over 8,200 yards and broke Carson Palmer's school records. Carson Palmer, is he a Hall of Famer in the NFL? Maybe.
Maybe not.
Wow, kind
of
quick.
End of the third quarter.
End of the third quarter. Here in Sydney, New South Wales, Australia, the tight end has been the main weapon for the Stanford Cardinal. They lead it 52-0. And the citizens of this great city have been very receptive to us all week long into these two programs. So much to offer. And for Stanford, the damage has been done already. 52-0. Scarlett and Love combining for nearly 300 yards of total offense, not to mention the Cardinal D.
Yeah, the city, I can't overemphasize the city of Sydney, just as ingratiating and welcoming as you could be.
With time. And the catch made by Smith. A leaping grab over the defender, eBay in coverage. Well, Parkinson's almost at 100 yards through the air and three touchdowns. Smith, Harrington, Schultz, it's a gain of 28, have also done a remarkable job.
And again, the ball completed to a tight end, Caden Smith. I asked Brian Stewart, the Rice defensive coordinator, I said, hey, what package would you rather see? The big package with all the tight ends or the spread package with receivers? He said, I'd rather see the spread. And I think I know why now. It's become very clear. The tight ends at Stanford, they're deep, they're fast, and they attack the ball.
And a 2-yard pickup on first down, Quentin.
Roy, they like to call themselves tight end U. And I spent some time with Scooter Harrington, who's like fourth on that list this week. Kid from New England, and I said, how many schools could you have considered to play tight end? He says, there's only about 30 schools right now that actually use a tight end, 12 of those, about a dozen, in an NFL-style tight end. That's what you get here at Stanford. That's why continually they bring in the top one or two tight ends. It's really a great prep for the NFL.
Line of scrimmage U, I think, would make a lot of sense for Stanford as well.
That's a great point, though. I mean, a lot of teams don't even have tight ends.
Another reception by Smith. Caden Smith being featured on this possession. It's a gain of 17. Banks brought him down.
And I'll say this, everything goes in cycles with football. I mean, you'll see the tight end, he'll emerge back in many, many programs. People will get tired of the spread, this up-tempo, this zone read offense all the time. Line up, and here's the great, you know, math of David Shaw. Hey, listen, I'm just gonna keep the chains moving. I'm gonna eat up the clock, and then the game will be over, and we'll have the lead. And in many, many, many of his wins, that's the recipe.
Stello simply had to get rid of that football as quickly as possible. Now 3 of 4 on this possession for 54 yards.
Uretzky. Intentional grounding. The pass was across the line of scrimmage.
Applied the pressure for Rice.
You know, Roy, one of the most remarkable stats coming into this game, I mean, Stanford under, you see the Rice Owls defensively, points allowed. That was last year, over 500 yards, and 580 today. Ouch. Of all of Stanford's wins coming into this year, they have 74 wins against FBS opponents this decade. Only one team has more, 79. Who is it?
Bama.
Bama.
Well, the curious conversation, I think, with Keller Chris, he's going to improve to 7-0 as a starter. The naysayers out there would say, okay, that's fantastic, but who have you beaten? Because we saw Ryan Burns last year have to face the likes of Washington and Washington State. So this next game for Stanford at SC is going to really tell us a lot about Chris and what this team is capable of this season.
Yeah, they beat SC. It was up at the farm last year in their 3 Pac-12 losses last year. They did not rush for over 100 yards. Washington, Washington State, and Colorado, they were all under total yards rushing. They were under the 100-yard mark.
Looking for Stewart. And shoved out of bounds. Pass is ruled incomplete. Bickham in coverage. Costello's looked impressive. I mean, he's throwing the ball in a frozen rope out there, and he doesn't seem to really be bothered by some of this pressure he's seeing.
I like Costello. The ball comes out quick. He's got a great arm and a really quick release, and that will get him. What I see early in the season with a lot of quarterbacks, the ball just doesn't come out quick enough. Guys want to make sure it's a clean picture and a clean read, and Costello today, he looks sharp. The ball's coming out quick.
Toner will attempt his second field goal of the afternoon. Connected from 40 yards out, his first drive. This one from 34 on the right hash, and he bangs it home. 55 points on the board for Stanford. And after the Stanford field goal, well, the fight is over. No, the fight here, it's a double nickel. 55-0 Cardinal. Rolling over Rice.
Stanford, it'll be a sobering reality when they get back from this long flight and realize, okay, yeah, we got a couple days off, maybe one. And you have to go down to Southern Cal and play the Trojans in the Coliseum. And it's a tall order. They're playing well. Sam Darnold, one of the best throwers in the country.
Nice pass from Glazeman, incomplete.
And SC was not happy with their loss at Stanford last year. Not at all.
Well, the good news for the Cardinal, you're not playing next weekend, so you get that weekend off. You get a little bit of time to recover after the jet lag, and it is severe, 15-hour flight, basically back to SFO. That'll come early tomorrow morning. And really, you got to believe, Tom, they'll emerge from this one relatively unscathed. Right. third and short. That'll be good enough to move the chains. But to me, it comes down to that game against SC. We talked about it. Washington State and UW as well in November, about 6 days apart. Those two teams took Stanford behind the woodshed last year. That can't happen this season to win the Pac-12 North.
Well, you got to run the football in the Pac-12. As much as it's a glamorous conference with great quarterbacks throwing the ball all over the yard, you have got to run the football and control the line of scrimmage. And number four, USC, they run the ball well, too. And they will come attack and play great defense right behind it. So that will be a huge challenge out the gate for Stanford.
Play action for Glazeman. Will float this one to his fullback. Masuba, 5'11", 230. A leaping grab. The drive continues. It's a gain of 22.
And the nice thing when you play a 3-4 base, you can actually sink down one of your linebackers and kind of, you know, I like number 21 who's in the game right now, Curtis Robinson. And that was a nice pass and catch that time by Rice. But Curtis Robinson, keep an eye on him, number 21 for Stanford. I think he's going to be a playmaker for the Cardinal down the line this season. He was a true freshman last year, not a lot of true freshmen play in that defense. And I think high expectations for 21.
And Robinson right on cue, bats that one down.
You know, he's big enough, you know, 6'3", 235. He's big enough. You can play on the end of the line of scrimmage. He can play the edge, and he can hold the edge if they come his way. So that's what I like about him. He jumped out at me at practice the other day. I'm like, Lance, wait, who's that guy? Who's 21? I want to know more about 21. And he had two sacks last year in the Rice game, so he came out of his shell last year.
Great conversation this week with Lance Anderson. He's been at Stanford for 11 years. Defensive play caller, great energy. I told him, it sounds like this is your first day on the job. You're so excited. There goes Walter, and Rice is on the board. And how about this crowd coming to life late?
Fire up that cannon. Look out, Sean Maloney. The cannon's going to blast again.
Austin Walter, twin brother Aston, a running back. It's a 23-yard touchdown run. Rice on the board. They'll avoid the shutout. That streak was in jeopardy, not since 2000, of the Owls. Been shut out.
Look out below! Looks like a couple mad scientists down there stuffing the muzzle of the... Rice on the board. Stanford, 55-7.
Cardinal of Stanford out of the Pac-12, dropping a double nickel against Rice. The Owls have scratched the scoreboard finally, 55-7. And a penalty. First and 10, 5 minutes remaining here in Sydney. Costello with all kinds of time. Fires that pass wide. It's incomplete. Well, the folks here in Sydney have been so gracious in welcoming us, our crew, both of these programs, Tom Ramsey, Roy Philpott, and you know, you can't say enough about what this experience has been like. And for these two teams, you know, most of these players haven't been out of the country before. So, you know, the Sydney Cup has been an incredible success.
Really is, really has been. Second year in a row for the Sydney Cup. And I think from an overall, the city has been fantastic, very welcoming. And it really, truly, it has been a great experience for both programs, Rice and Stanford. I know that they've really enjoyed it. The harbor cruise, when they had dinner, they couldn't talk enough about it. They visited the zoo, and I believe they did a little community service as well. And really, I think, benefits Sydney, and it just opens up more ways for American football to be seen across the globe, which I always think is great. And being the first day of college football kicking off, Roy, I mean, great place to kick it off.
Now, the future of the sport, as you take a look at the itineraries, the total miles traveled, is probably going to be international. And you try to take American football overseas, it's happened at times with varying degrees of success, but you're going to see more of this kind of thing moving forward.
Well, the NFL's done a great job, right? Opening up London, playing games over there, down in Mexico City. And here in Australia, I really think they love American football. Talking to talking to Big Sean Maloney before the match today. I'll call it the match on the pitch.
On the pitch. Well done.
Australians really, they love sport. And so American football blends right in. And, you know, rugby is kind of the king of the hill here. But American football is quite the game. And I think there's a lot of spectators here today enjoying the game and will be in future matches as well.
30,000 were expected at Allianz Stadium. It seats about 40. The Sydney Roosters, the rugby league down under. Weddington, second reception in as many plays. Cricket grounds are right behind us. The Swans play just across the street. A lot of questions this week from the citizens here in Sydney just about the sport and exactly how it's played. Here's a look at the cricket grounds. Talk about an impressive facility. Well, they run about half of a marathon during some of these games in Australian rules football. It's so physical, rugby obviously as well. Half a marathon. I don't think I could do that right now if you paid me.
No.
In fact, I know I could.
Is that one of those stickers on your car? Is this 13.1? Is that? Should I get one?
Maddox, a short pickup. Third down. Time winding down. Approaching 2.5 to play. No major surprises today. Maybe Colorado State pouring it on Oregon State. Fort Collins, that was a little bit of a surprise, perhaps.
And yeah.
South Florida scoring 42 unanswered. San Jose State, Quentin Flowers, we know what kind of damage he can do this year at quarterback. Question is next weekend. Thursday, Ohio State, Indiana, Bama, Florida State, West Virginia, Virginia Tech, all those great matchups. It'll be here before you know it. Costello flush, straight ahead, with some daylight towards the end zone for the touchdown. And Toner will make it 62. And one more fire, the cannon, 62-7 the score. Costello with the honors, his first touchdown. Just across the harbor here in Sydney, Australia, down under. What a week it has been. I'm Ramsey, Roy Philpotts. Here in the booth, Quinn Kestick, Sean Maloney down on the sidelines. Beautiful weather today, as it's been most of the week. It's wintertime here in the southern hemisphere, so it's been quite chilly. Temperatures in the upper 40s. Not as cold as this Rice offense has been for the better part of these four quarters.
Yeah, definitely cooling off period for the Rice offense. They need to heat it up just a little bit.
And most people forget Stanford under David Charles won 11 games or more four times in six seasons. So they literally have done everything but make the playoff. We're going to find out a lot about this program in 2 weeks. At SC. Ready. 30 seconds remaining. Claisman in his first start. Hit forward to the 45. Well, nobody has been as consistent as David Shaw and Stanford. Claisman had it fall out of his grasp. It's going to be picked off by Swan. Big fellow rumbled down to the 45 on what will be the next to last play of this football game here in Sydney.
And Lance Taylor was the coach he lost, the former running backs coach who's now the wide receivers coach at the NFL Panthers. So he kind of went as a package deal with McCaffrey off to the Panthers. How happy is Swan? He can come away and go, hey, I got an interception.
Von Swan, a sophomore from Indiana. Tell you what, it makes that flight home a little faster, doesn't it? Don't forget Sports Hitter coming up next. We'll send you over to Steve Levy back in Bristol as soon as we're done here in Sydney. Fun week for all of us for the Sydney Cup. And back at the farm, a lot of happy Stanford fans. Jack Richardson in at quarterback. It should be the final play. 62-7. David Shaw feeling good about this trip overseas. Nearly 8,000 miles from home. The Cardinal get the job done.
Well, David Shaw did say he wanted to see his team in action. I think he saw plenty today.
62-7, the final. SportsCenter coming up right now as we send you up to Steve Levy.